In order to understand the most powerful chant on Lord Shiva, which is Shri Rudram, also called as Rudra Prashnaha or Rudradhyayi, we need to understand the nature of that aspect of creation which is referred to as Rudra. The word Rudra has multiple interpretations in Sanskrit language. Roditi, Rodayati iti Rudraha. The one who roars and causes a roar is Rudra. Rudhiram Dravayati iti Rudraha. The one who bursts forth with a reddish hue is Rudra. The closest English translation for the word Rudra is a roar or a burst or an explosion of energy. Rudra is that explosive energy of a flash of lightning, of an erupting volcano, of the jutting up of dormant kundalini, and the very first bang that sprang forth material creation. In a personified form, this aspect of creation is worshipped as a fierce form of Lord Shiva. In fact, of this aspect itself, there are 11 different manifestations called as Ekadasha Rudras. In this video, let us understand each of these 11 manifestations along with their symbolism and significance. The Sanskrit channel does not run on ads. It runs on your support. In order to help us avoid distracting advertisements in our many chants and explainer videos, consider becoming a sponsor on Patreon or make a one-time contribution through these options. Check out the links in the description below to access live Q&A sessions and hundreds of downloadable resources. There are various fantastic stories in the Puranas which describe the origin of the 11 Rudras differently, with different names ascribed to them. These stories might seem like fictional tales at first, but they contain within them some of the most profound secrets of creation, conveyed in the form of beautiful fables. Without going into the story aspect of these Puranas, let us try and look at them from an analytical point of view. Bhagavata Purana mentions that Lord Brahma created 11 different forms of Rudra by the names of Manyu, Manu, Mahinasa, Mahan, Shiva, Ritadhvaja, Ugraretas, Bhava, Kala, Vamadeva, and Dhritavrata. The corresponding feminine aspects of these energies are known by the names of Dhi, Dhriti, Rasala, Uma, Niyut, Sarpi, Ila, Ambika, Iravati, Swadha, and Diksha. These masculine and feminine energies correspond to 11 different aspects of human creation, like Hridaya or the heart, not the blood pumping organ, but the seat of feelings and sensations, Indriya, the sense organs, Asu, the life breath, Vyoma, the primordial element of space, Vayu, the air element, Agni, the fire element, Jalam, the water element, Mahi, the earth element, Surya, the sun, Chandra, the moon, and Tapas, the radiance that is brought about through austerities. The nature of these 11 manifestations of explosive energy and the various aspects of creation that they correspond to are things that one has to discover for oneself experientially. It is no coincidence that Sri Rudram, which is in the worship of Lord Rudra too, has 11 segments or anuvakas. The practice of this chant invokes these specific energies, wards off the negative influences, and bestows the benefits corresponding to each of these aspects of creation in one's own life. I'll be honest with you, I'm nowhere near understanding Sri Rudram for all it has to offer. I'm as much a student as you are, with the slight advantage of having started this study a little earlier. The true essence of what each of these aspects mean and the possibilities that they hold are as much a mystery to me as they are to you. But the journey of unlocking these secrets and realizing their significance through deep contemplation, aided by one's own spiritual sadhana, is an extremely rewarding process, and that is what we'll try to attempt in this series. With this understanding of both the abstract notion of what Rudra represents and the various ways in which he is represented, invoked, and worshipped, let us now begin our journey of exploring the secrets of Sri Rudram in our upcoming videos. Please make sure that you gently tap on that like button so that YouTube recommends this video to more people. And if you wish to support the production of more videos like these directly, consider becoming a sponsor on Patreon or make a one-time contribution, all through the links in the description below. See you in the next video. Namaskaram.